Lynn Merrifield, Clive McGrory, Janie Orr and Tina McGeever all made their voices heard by petitioning the Scottish Parliament.
2.5 years ago, my son went from nursery to school and I was just horrified to find that he was put on a double-decker bus without any safety belts, no supervision at all. And I just didn't find that acceptable.
I thought something should be done about people with disabilities to try and get work from home. Seems that if you're in employment or there's an offer of a job on the table, the Discrimination Act can work for you. If, however, you're like me and the 500,000 people that are out there, it just doesn't work. It's as simple as that. So I thought I would raise a petition to try and create awareness of this.
People my age were trying to get to social activities and further education opportunities, but they couldn't get them because they didn't have the bus service to do it. So me and some of my friends got together, we made a petition for the Scottish Parliament to see what they could do in solving the problem.
My petition was urging the government to take action basically on equity of drugs, in particular cetuximab, for people who are terminally ill, and it was on behalf of my husband, Mike Gray.
Well, I think the Public Petitions Committee is one of the great strengths of this Parliament. The founding fathers of this Parliament thought that having a strong system where ordinary individuals could approach the Parliament to look at their issues, their worries, their concerns. And in fact, people from technically all over the world can raise petitions as long as it's a responsibility of the Scottish Government.
Well, once I had made up my mind to put a petition forward, I then emailed the clerks and they basically walked me through the process. They answered all my questions, nothing was too much trouble, and they took me right forward to the time when I actually appeared in front of the committee itself.
Well, I was able to send in a rough draft of my petition and they were able to reword it so it sounded a lot better and sounded a lot more formal, and that was really, really helpful.
Within 30 minutes of sending off my petition by email, I had a call from the clerk who gave me advice on the wording of the petition itself.
It can be quite nerve-wracking to try and get your wording right on your petition to ensure that, you know, you've put as much information as possible across. So it was quite nice because I had the backup there of emailing the clerks to the committee to say, you know, have I got this right? Is there anything else I should be putting in? And it was really invaluable advice that I received, so it was very good.
If you go onto our website, you're able to download a template that can fill in the detail. But we've got a very strong team of clerks who are able to advise ordinary citizens about the day-to-day administration of filling in the paperwork and how they approach the committee. So I think that we're well served by that. But the key thing is that ordinary people can approach this committee and deal with the concerns and worries that they have.
Don't be afraid to just step over the line, because it can be daunting, and especially if you've never ever done anything like this before. But please do it, because it's really worthwhile.
I would certainly go down the road again if I felt strongly about an issue to bring something in front of the Public Petitions Committee. I felt very much backed up that someone was in my corner fighting for me as well.
If I thought I had something to say which could be of interest to the general public, or even if it was just straightforward and interest to my local area, I would have no hesitation in recommending anybody put forward a petition.
As a member of the Scottish Youth Parliament, a lot of issues do come up, and I think this would be a really, really valuable way to actually get them into the spotlight and get MSPs actually discussing the matter and getting something sorted out about it. So yes, I would definitely raise another petition, and I'd definitely say, especially to young people, to go out there and get a petition out there.